Sister Bunny is going to bless us with this one. Amen.
Lubongo kuhle angenze lekonu baba kungaqala kubonga izinyembezi zami kuhle angenzile kuhle uma ngaqala ngokuhle angenze lekonu baba kungaqala kubonga izinyembezi zami kuhle angenzile kuhle uma ngaqala kuqale sibalo kuhle angenzele kona kungaqala kubonga izinyembezi zami kuhle Oh,
You are faithful. You are faithful. Oh, you are faithful. You are faithful. Oh, Lord. Every day. Before the throne of grace, to thank you, Father, to love you, to adore you, and appreciate your holy name. Heavenly Father, I want to say thank you that you've gathered us together this evening in your wonderful name, and we pray that you may come and move, Lord God, in your own very special way. Take men of the sin and come and be seen, O Father. Lord God, we have come to trust and depend on you, and we know those that depend on you shall never be put to shame. You are still the same yesterday, today, and forever. You are a never-failing Jehovah. Bless us, Father God. Hide us behind the cross of Calvary. We are reporting for duty, Almighty God. Heavenly Father, bless the reading of the word. Bless the preaching of the word as we commit everything into your capable hands. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 God bless you, saints. To God be the glory. Read you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So happy to see you again in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's just read the scripture so that you may take your seats. It's in the book of Isaiah, chapter 57. Isaiah 57. I'm going to read one verse 15. Amen. Amen. We are certainly happy to be in the house of the Lord. He deserves all the honor. He is everything to us. Let's read that one verse. For thus saith the high and lofty one that inhabiteth eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place, with him also that is of a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the height of the contrite ones.
Ngokuba utsho ophezulu ongabeleyo ohleli ngonaphakade ogamali ngugcwele ukuthi ngihleli phezulu engcoleni ngihleli nokutyumkileyo omoya othobekileyo ukuba ndibuye ndiphilise umoya wabathobekileyo ndibuye ndiphilise intliziyo yabathobekileyo intliziyo yabathobekileyo.
May God add the blessings to the reading of his word. You may take your seats. Amen. Greetings once again in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I've got an apology from Brother Thandabantu. That he's not going to be able to make it tonight. He's still on his way from work. Amen. That's the apology that we've got. We also bring greetings from Mosselbay. From Pastor Ronnie and the saints there. We had wonderful services. They were not planned for long. Amen. It was difficult to go there. Thinking that for two Sundays I was not here. Yeah, so now, but we thank God that he undertook for everything. I believe you had a blessed time as well on Sunday. Amen. We thank the Lord for his blessings on us. Amen. He is a never-failing Jehovah. He remains the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. Looks like when you come in, Brother Elijah, you put Brother Sam under pressure. Amen. He feels like he's not. Yeah, so he feels like he needs a change. But Brother Elijah needs a break as well. Yeah, he needs a rest as well. Yeah, he needs to get some rest. He's gonna be busy on Sunday. Yeah. Okay. Amen. Don't feel no pressure. We're not gonna run today. Amen. God bless you. Yeah. No. Without wasting time. We wanna continue with the subject of Wednesday last week. Requirements for the revival. Amen. Requirements that we need to meet to be able to make a way for the revival. Amen. We went through some definitions of it last time, just to recap. So where we said, you know, when we look at the English explanation of what a revival is,
says
a revival, it came with multiple meanings. One of them is it means to come back to life. Where we say it's like somebody who had a heart attack and the heart has stopped. When you do the first aid and you whatever what the doctors do, whatever you call it, but you are bringing back life to that person. That person had life and life went. Now you are bringing life back. That's called a revival. You are reviving. The other one we said is to restore to strength or glory. The other one it was to renew the interest to something. So that was the English dictionary.
So
now the prophet said in the message, the angel of the Lord,
Umprofethi uthi kwintshumayelo ethi angel of the Lord.
Paragraph 16.
Paragraph 16.
Is telling us what the revival is.
Yes, says
when you see these crowds
gathering,
that doesn't mean revival. Amen. That's just a gathering. Amen.
Amen.
But a revival is when people get really right with God. When people get really right with God, that's a revival. And pray through. And start a revival throughout the city. Since you see, they put away sin. Put away their iniquity. Then turn to God. Turn around and start back again. Says that's a revival. When they put away their iniquity. When they put away sin. When they turn to God. Says that's a revival. Rabbanam says, you know, the church has become so lazy. It has become so dry. He says, in that, it has become an impossible thing to get people praying and fasting this day. Says, we need a revival. Says, the problem is, we spend too much time watching TV. We spend too much time reading the newspapers. We spend too much listening to things we ought not to be listening to. We spend too much time on social media such that God cannot do a revival in our lives. Amen. So in order to get that revival, we need to set ourselves aside and seek for the face of God. Take sin aside. Put away iniquity and seek for the face of God. Now I like what he says. Revival is not the gathering. Amen. It's not that doesn't mean a revival. Next time I'm gonna get to some coast to show you the bride's revival. Amen. We touched on that when we were in Mosul Bay. We were speaking on the bride's revival. Because Abraham says, in Gabriel's instruction to Daniel, he says the great Pentecostal revival is now ceasing.
That was in
1961. Amen. He says it's ceasing.
Uti iyaphela.
In 1965. Amen. He comes to say,
uza athi,
I'm no more looking for a revival.
And isakhangela imvuselelo.
In the message, Invisible Union of the Bride.
Umyalezo
uti, says, I'm not looking for the revival no more.
And isakhangela imvuselelo.
I'm looking for the coming of the Lord.
Ndijonge ukuza kwenkosi.
Amen.
Amen.
But here he says in 61, the great Pentecostal revival is now ceasing. Amen.
Amen.
Says we see it everywhere. The last great move says the message has gone forth. Everything is ready now waiting. The church is sealed away. The wicked are doing more wicked. Churches are becoming more churchy. The saints are coming closer to God. So we are not looking for a Pentecostal revival. That's not the one we are looking for. In the third seal, he comes and he says, the bride has not had her revival yet.
Umthakazi awukabina mvuselelo.
Yeah, he says,
apha 1961,
the revival is ceasing.
1965 says, I'm not no more looking for a revival. I'm looking for the coming of the Lord. Referring to the Pentecostal revival. Because in 1961, he was telling us it's ceasing. But in 1963, when he preaches the third seal, he says the bride has not had a revival yet. Says it will take those seven unknown thunders to awaken her, that she may have a revival. In that same message, Invisible Union of the Bride, when you go down, he says, watch when the bride starts to have her revival. In the quote before, he says, I'm not looking for a revival, because he speaks about the Pentecostal revival. The one that is ceasing, but now it's turning to a bright revival. And that bright revival is not a revival of gathering. It's not a revival of jumping up and down. It's not a revival of singing. Brother, we can have a concert for that. That's not a revival. But it's the revival of the word. It starts with the opening of the word, and it goes on to the changing of the body. Because he says it will be those unknown thunders, which is the opening of the word, because he says the seven thunders are this divinely revealed mystery truth. Says that's what will bring a revival to the bride. Amen.
Amen.
Then we read a quote in God Called Man last week Wednesday, where Brother Branham said, you know, put some requirements for a revival. When God is about to send a revival, he says he can't send a revival until he gets men in shape to take that revival. So there must be men in shape to take the revival. He says, God called men. God trained men. Rugged men of faith. Amen. That are trained in God's school of ruggedness. He says, men who are not afraid to face the fire. Men who know the presence of God, who have been in the presence of God and know the power of God. Men who will go to the fight and stand for God, whether it's victory or defeat. Says those are the men that will take the revival. They know God's power. They have been in the presence of the Lord. They know thus saith the Lord. They are in shape for a revival. And they are not looking for it in a gathering. It's just like when Prabhupada speaks about that Welsh revival. He says there was a revival that was happening in Wales. Then there came a delegation of men from America. From America.
Yeah.
That went to Wales.
Ah, yeah, Wales.
They were looking for the Welsh revival.
Ah, yeah.
When they got to Wales,
ah, yeah, Wales.
They saw a policeman.
Ah, bona, I police.
Amen. Who was on the road there.
Yeah,
and he was full of joy.
Lino vuyo.
He was carrying his baton. And he was playing with it. He was happy in joy. Amen. And this man sent, they went to this man. Says, tell us, we are looking for the building where the Welsh revival is taking place. And that man says, you have arrived. You don't have to look no more. They ask, what do you mean? He says, I am the world's reviver. I am packing the world's reviver. These men are looking for a gathering. They are looking for a building with people where there's some speaking in tongues and miracles and jumping up and down and crying. But here is this policeman. Says, don't look no more. It's in me. That's the revival we're talking about. The revival in individuals where people have been taken back to life.
Amen.
Amen. People that knows God. People that approaches God according to his requirements. Let's turn to the book of 1 Samuel. Chapter 4. 1 Samuel chapter 4. Let's get something here.
Amen.
1 Samuel chapter 1.
Chapter 1.
No, in 1 Samuel chapter 1.
Or 1 Samuel chapter 1.
There Hannah is praying and crying. For a son.
For unyana.
And she receives a son.
Uyam fumana unyana.
You know, chapter 2.
Of Luke chapter 2.
There Samuel is born. A prophet's son and given back to God. Amen. And she grows in the Lord. Chapter 3. We find there Samuel. You know where God speaks to him. And Eli tells him, you know, when you hear him calling again, you must say, hey, here I am, speak my Lord. And the Lord spoke to Samuel in chapter
3.
And here, so Samuel, he was a prophet. He was a priest. He was a judge. And there was no prophet for a space of time. It was during the time of the judges before then. But here God raised a prophet. Name of Samuel. Now in chapter 4.
Chapter
4. Here we see something. Samuel being in his office.
Samuel
He says in verse 1,
and
the word of Samuel was the prophet. So in other words, in our day, we would say the word of Branham. Or the word of the prophet. Amen. The word of Samuel came to all Israel. To all Israel. We are not told what he said. We don't know what was that word. But the word of Samuel was the word of God. Because he was a prophet. So it came via Samuel. To all Israel. Amen.
Amen.
Now it says, now Israel went out against the Philistines to battle. And pitched beside Ebenezer, and the Philistines pitched in Afek. Amen. So here we see, after the word of Samuel, we don't know what Samuel said. But after that word, the Israelites went to fight the Philistines. They went to battle against the Philistines. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, in verse 2, and the Philistines put themselves in array against Israel. And when they joined the battle, Israel was smitten before the Philistines. And they slew of the army of the field, about 4,000 men.
As the Amaphilisti Aka Ulu Lokulu and Amasraeli, Itabi Lanwenezela, Abulawa Amasraeli, Pambi Guamaphilisti, Guabulawa Eluhuini, Etafeni Apo Amatota Amawaka Amani.
4,000 men died.
Amatota Amawaka Amani.
To me, it just tells me. They did not go according to the word of Samuel. The word of Samuel went to them. Whatever Samuel said, they did not go according to the word of Samuel. Just like the word of Micaiah went to Ahab and them, but they did not go according to the word of Micaiah. Amen.
Amen.
The word of the prophet went to all the Israel. It's not like the word was not there. The word was there. But
Israel
had their own revival. They went into the battle and 4,000 men died. They went on their own and 4,000 men died. Then in verse 3 it says, and when the people were coming to the camp, the elders of Israel said, wherefore had the Lord smitten us today before the Philistines?
Beza abantu eminqubeni athi amadoda amakhulu akwaIsrayeli. Yini na ukuba uYehova asibulale namhla phambi kwamaFilisti?
They doing an introspection.
Ayazikhangela.
Why did we lose?
4,000
men died. You know, let us check what has happened. We are Israel, the chosen ones. God is on our side. Why did the Philistines lose us? Then they go on and says, let us fetch the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord out of Shiloh unto us. That when it come among us, it may save us out of the hand of our enemies. So they went to battle without the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord. They went to battle not carrying the Ark of the Covenant. Now the Ark of the Covenant was the like the Bible today. The Word of God today. The Bible today. So they went to battle without that. Don't forget the Word of Samuel went to them. And the word of Samuel will be it's the word of the hour. Amen.
Amen.
Because the word is not, you know, in the beginning was the word. Not in the beginning was the Bible. In the beginning was the word. So when the prophet and the Bible aligns, because it's the Bible that says, it's the Bible that says a virgin shall conceive. But that's not the word of today. That's not the word of today. But it is the Bible. So here they come. Says, no, let us go and take the Ark of the Covenant that it may save us. Now look at this. So the people sent to Shiloh that they might bring forth the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord of hosts, which dwelleth between the cherubims, and the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were there with the Ark of the Covenant of God.
Bathumelake abantu eShilo bayithabatha khona itye yomnqophiso kaYehova wemikhosi ohleli phezu kwekherubi babe khona bobabini onyana baka Eli uYafoni noPhinehasi benetye yomnqophiso kaThixo.
So they went and took this Ark of the Covenant, even with the two backslidden sons of Hophni.
Onyana abawileyo baka
Of Eli, sorry.
Like Eli.
You know, Hophni and Phinehas.
Hophni no Phinehas.
These backslidden priests. They came carrying that Ark of the Covenant. And here Israel is rejoicing. Because all we need is the Ark of the Covenant. Don't forget the word of Samuel, the word of the Lord went to them. They are not going back to what Samuel said. They are trying to go into battle in their own way. They say, what we missed? We missed to carry the Bible. Let's go back to the Ark of the Covenant. And we've got our priests here, Hophni and Phinehas. They will come with the Ark of the Covenant for us. Backslidden priests that were not
under the prophet of their day. That's why any priest today, not under the prophet, can never lead you to salvation. Never. Amen.
Amen.
Read, you know, you go to verse 5. And when the ark of the covenant of the Lord came into the camp, all Israel shouted with a great shout, so that the earth rang again.
Kwathi xa ifika ityeyo mnqophiso kaYehova eminqubeni, aduma kakhulu onke amaSrayeli, umhlaba wathi ndi.
In our words of today, we would say it was a great revival. It was a great revival. All Israel was gathered together. The priests were carrying the Bible. There was Hophni. Oh, what a message he gave. What a message he gave. Right from the Ark of the Covenant.
Amen.
He preached right from the Bible. There was a big great shout. A great noise. They were so revived. According to the words of today, they were so happy. But brother, let me tell you, revival is not emotions. Revival is not enthusiasm. Revival is not entertainment. What they were having here,
amen.
What they were having here was just emotions. What they were having here was just a zeal. What they were having here was just enthusiasm. But there was a shout. Brother, there was a shout. Amen. Everybody was jumping up and down until you could be sure the Holy Ghost has fallen here. Everybody is shouting and jumping and clapping. And they call it a revival. And when the Philistines heard the noise of the shout, they said, what means the noise of this great shout, verse 6, in the camp of the Hebrews? And they understood that the ark of the Lord was come into the camp.
Afiva amafilisi isandi sokuduma kwawo. Athi, sesani na esisandi sokuduma kangaka eminqubeni yamaHebhere. Azike ukuba itsheya kaYehova ifikile eminqubeni.
Listen to verse 7. And the Philistines were afraid.
Amafilisti oyika.
For they said, God is coming to the camp. That revival of theirs looked so real. It looked so powerful. Until the enemy now was scared. Because they were saying God is with them. They were looking at what was happening. Powerful preachings. Powerful singings. Amens that were on the higher levels.
Oh, amen.
And the hall was full. Stadium was full, brother. Until the enemy could say, God is there. God is in that revival. That's how happy they, you know, that's how afraid the Philistines became. Amen.
Amen.
And they said, who unto us? For there has not been such a thing heretofore. Verse 7.
Yeah, ke kuthi. Yeah, ke tina. Ngokuba akuzanga kube nje ngaphambi.
Who unto us? Who shall deliver us out of the hand of these mighty gods? These are the gods that smote the Egyptians with all the plagues in the wilderness.
Yeah, get in Angubanina Oya Kusisangula, Esanden Sabatiko, Babungangamsha, Bungaga, Goba, Gabatiko, Ababulala, Amayiputa.
Verse 9, be strong and quit yourselves like men, O you Philistines, that you be not servants unto Hebrews as they have been to you. Quit yourselves like men and fight.
Yomelelani nibe ngamadoda, nina mafilisti, hleze nikhonze kumaHebhere, njengokuba ekhonze kuni wona, yibani ngamadoda, nilwe.
So the Philistines were saying,
amafilisti,
what good is it gonna do?
Iyawusenzela ntoni loo nto?
To just give up.
Into basinikezele.
You see, they were so weak, brother.
Ayebuthathaka.
They were so weakened.
Yeah,
they were so defeated even before they start to fight. Amen.
Amen.
But they say, let us just go and fight.
God, again,
and verse 10 says, and the Philistines fought, and Israel was smitten. And they fled every man into his tent, and there was a great slaughter, for there fell of Israel 30,000 footmen.
Alwa ke ama Filisti, awabulala ama Israeli, asaba ke wona, waya elo entende liyake, abula waka kulugunene, kwa waku ma Filisti, okuma Israeli, ama waka angama shumi matatu, amkikela.
And the ark of God was taken, and the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were slain.
Watinjwa nekeya yomnopiso katiko, bafa onyana bobabini baka Eli, uofeni no Phinehasi.
You look at this.
Uchonga up.
Philistines were not even prepared.
Ama Philisti ayenga zilungisi
lano. They were even scared.
Ayeso yika.
They did not even want to go and fight.
Ayenga funoku yoku.
Yeah, the people.
Kodwa abantu apa.
That are supposedly in the will of the Lord.
Aba bebekufanele basenda
tandweni kaThixo. Carrying the word of God.
Bephethiliswe likaThixo.
They were smitten. They were slaughtered. 30,000 of them died. If you add the other 4,000, now the total was 34,000. That revival caused 34,000 souls to die, including their priests. Their priests, Hophni and Phinehas, died. The revival did not bring a healing to them. Why? It did not bring healing. It brought death, including the death of the priests carrying the ark of the covenant, shouting and happy that the ark of the covenant is in the camp. Amen. But that's not what God was looking at. It started by saying, the word of the prophet went to them. We don't know what the prophet says, but through all what they are doing, it's not going back to the word of the prophet. They want a revival outside the word of the prophet. They want a revival in their own way, because they've got priests that can interpret the ark of the covenant. They've got priests that can carry the ark of the covenant. And they are not even looking at the lives of those priests. That is backslidden priesthood. 34,000 people.
34,000
men died.
Amen.
Amen. Including, and the ark was taken. The ark was taken by the Philistines. And Israel was scared.
Israel was scared.
They became afraid. Let's jump to chapter 7.
Chapter 7.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm talking about the requirements for the revival. It's not just about the noise and being happy and emotions.
Amen.
Amen. It's not even about carrying the Bible with us and having the priests with us. Let's go to 1 Samuel chapter
7.
Verse 1. And the men of Kijah Jearim came and fetched up the ark of the Lord and brought it into the house of Abinadab in the hill and sanctified Eliezer his son to keep the ark of the Lord.
Aza amadoda ekiriyati ye harim.
Hey, this word is ayinyusa
ityeya kaYehova ayizisa endlwini ka Abinadabi endulini angcwalisa uElezare unyana wakhe ukuba ayigcine ityeya kaYehova.
The ark did not belong to the Philistines.
Ityeya ibinga ibingeyo yama Philisti.
Belongs to the Israelites.
Ibe yama Israel.
And it came to pass while the ark abode in Kijah Jearim that the time was long, for it was 20 years
and all the house of Israel lamented after the Lord.
Kwathi ihleli eKiriyati yeHarim apho itheya zanda insuku zayiminyaka emashumi mabini yamlandela uYehova ngesimema yonke indlu kaIsrayeli.
Between chapter 4 and chapter 7 you don't hear about Samuel again.
Phakathi ko chapter 4 no chapter 7 awuphindanga wayava ngo Samuel.
Last time we hear about Samuel is verse 1 of chapter 4.
Ugqibela kwethu kuva ngo Samuel simgqibele ku verse 1 ku chapter 4.
And they went into their own revival and they were defeated and they died.
Baziyela kwimvuselelo yabo baboyiswa bafa.
So we never heard about Samuel.
Asiphindanga savanga ngo Samuel.
And the Bible says it was 20 years since that defeat.
IBhayibhile ithi yayiminyaka engamashumi amabini ukusukela
ngoboyiswa. These people were willing to stay 20 years without the ark.
Aba bantu bahlala iminyaka eyi-20 ngaphandle kwelizwi.
20 years without going back to the prophet.
Because
they were so disappointed.
Ngoba bebephoxekile.
That the revival in their own way backfired.
Ngoba imvuselelo ibiye yabo yohlulwe.
Amen.
Amen.
Verse 3 says, now we hear about Samuel again.
Verse 3 is siphinda siva ngo Samuel.
And Samuel spake unto all the house of Israel, saying,
wathi ke uSamuel kwindlu ka kwindlu yonke kaIsrayeli.
We heard in chapter 4 verse 1.
Sivile ku chapter 4
verse
1.
The word of Samuel
uba ilizwi
lika Samuel went into all Israel.
Laya kuma Israel.
We never heard what it says.
As last baliteni.
But again here.
Apha kokona.
The word of Samuel
ilizwi lika Samuel
goes to all Israel.
Laya kuwo
onke. But here now it tells us.
Apha liyasixelela.
It said,
lithi,
if you do return unto the Lord with all your hearts, then put away the strange gods and Ashtaroth from among you and prepare your hearts unto the Lord and serve him only. He will deliver you out of the hands of the Philistines.
Ukuba nibuyela kuYehova ngenhliziyo yenu yonke, basuseni ke phakathi kwenu othixo bolunye, uhe uyi anga no Ashtaroti. Nizimise inhliziyo zenu kuYehova nikhonze yena yedwa woni hlangula ke esandleni samaFilisti.
He's telling them,
uyabaxelela,
it's, you know, how to get right,
ulungisa
njani, how to get this revival,
uzilungisa njani
imvuselelo. Says return unto the Lord with all your heart,
buyelani kuYehova ngenhliziyo yenu yonke.
It won't be a half-hearted thing, this thing.
Ayo bantu izaba half.
You can't go with reservation in this thing.
Amen.
You will have to go and return to the Lord with all your heart. Take away all your strange gods. All these things that hinders you. You must kill them. You must remove them. Amen. And prepare your hearts for the Lord. And serve God only. And if you do that, he will deliver you from the hand of the Philistines. You know, the Philistines were the enemy that was close to the Israel. Internal enemy. And there were other nations that had their own countries. It was external enemies. But Philistines were close enemies. Internal enemies. They needed to fight with those first. And it's like that in our lives. You've got enemies in your life that are external and enemies that are internal that have to do with your soul. Amen.
Amen.
So there are things you must defeat that are internal, that are hindering you from serving the Lord. You must kill those things. It's internal enemies. You know, you must kill lying.
It's an internal enemy. You must kill lust. It's an internal enemy. You must kill unforgiveness. It's an internal enemy. They are internal. They are Philistines. In your life, you must deal with enemies that are internal. I know there are external enemies. There are things you deal with from outside. But before you deal with those ones, kill your Philistines first. Deal with your Philistines first. Because that's a dangerous enemy. The one that is close, the one that is internal, that's a dangerous one. So Israel had to deal with the Philistines. But in order to deal with the Philistines, in order to kill the internal enemies, they had to return unto God with all of their heart. You're not going to defeat your internal sins unless you return unto God with all of your heart. Unless you kill self.
Hey, we preached in Stellenbosch last week, Friday, where Paul was saying, I have put a death sentence unto self. I put a death sentence on self. He says, because I was in a deep trouble until I even desired to die. I did not know how to get out of it. And he says, I put a death sentence unto self. He says, we were pressed out of measure. Until we despaired even to life.
Desa, desa.
Sa, sa, sa. Ya, kwa, kwa, sa, 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 kwa, kubunzi manopil.
Amen.
Amen. He says, then we put a death sentence to self. That we should not trust in ourselves. But trust in the Lord. Says, when we did that, the Lord delivered. And he will yet deliver. Now, to deal with the Philistines, you must kill self. You must die to self. So that it's no longer me that lives. It must be Christ that lives in me. Amen.
Amen.
You must not trust in self. You must not have confidence in self. Because self comes with Philistines. So the word of Samuel tells them, amen, that if you do return unto the Lord with all of your heart and put away strange gods, Astaroth from among you,
O Astaroth,
and prepare your hearts unto the Lord and serve him only. And serve him only. He will deliver you. You are not able to defeat many things about yourself. Brother, how do you get divine love on your own self? How do you get to forgive on your own self? There are things, brother, that are difficult to forgive. If you go by self, you need to turn your heart to the Lord. You need to kill self. Then he will deliver you from the Philistines. Says, then the children of Israel did put away Baalim and Ashtaroth and served the Lord only.
Verse 4.
And Samuel said, gather all Israel to Mizpah, and I will pray for you unto the Lord.
What you Samuel uhlanganiseni. Wahlanganiseleni emizpa onke amaIsrayeli ndinithandazele kuYehova.
And they gathered together to Mizpah and drew water and poured it out before the Lord and fasted on that day and said there, we have sinned against God. And Samuel judged the children of Israel in Mizpah.
Ahlanganisana emizpa akha amanzi awaphalaza phambi kuYehova. azila ukudla ngalo mini athi khona sonile kuYehova wabalawula uSamuel onke onyana bakaIsrayeli.
This is a heart that's preparing for a revival.
Inhliziyo elungiselelwe
imvuselelo. If the people that are called by my name
ukuba abantu babizwa ngegama lam
shall humble themselves and pray
bazithobe bathandaze
and turn away from their wicked ways
baguquke kubugwenxa babo,
then I will hear from heaven and I will take away their sins
ndiyakuzithabathela ndizizwe
and I will answer them. These are the people now. They are submitting to the word of somewhere. They are not now moving in their own zeal. Now they are listening to what Samuel says. And they do, and they come with a repenting heart. Says, we have sinned against the Lord. We have sinned against the Lord. And even somewhere becomes the judge to them.
Amen.
And when the verse 7, when the Philistines heard that the children of Israel were gathered together to Mizpah, the lords of the Philistines went up against Israel. And when the children of Israel heard it, they were afraid of the Philistines.
Eva amaFilisti ukuba onyana bakaIsrayeli bahlanganisene eMizpah, zenyuka izikhulu zamaFilisti zawaphumela amaIsrayeli. Beva onyana bakaIsrayeli bawoyika amaFilisti.
They were afraid of the Philistines.
Oyika amaFilisti.
Now they did not trust in themselves.
Abazithemba.
Now they did not trust in the in their own ability.
Abazithemba ngakwamandla.
They did not trust in their backslidden priests.
Abathemba ababingeleli
babo. They remembered 20 years ago.
Bakhumbula iminyaka engamashumi amabili.
The mistake that we did.
Impazamo esayenzayo.
34,000 men that died.
Amadoda ayi 34 afayo.
Says now they were afraid.
Aqalisa ukoyika.
Amen. And the Bible says,
the Bible it is.
And the children of Israel said to Samuel, cease not to cry unto the Lord, our God for us, that he will save us out of the hand of the Philistines.
But onyana bakaIsrayeli kuSamueli, musa ukuyeka ukusikhalela kuYehova, uThixo wethu.
Now this was a humble spirit. This was a contrite heart. Amen. This was a heart now. According to Isaiah
57.
Verse 15 that could be revived by God.
Verse 15.
Now they are coming and say to the prophet, don't stop praying for us. We don't depend on ourselves. We are trusting in God. Brother Branham says, the success of my ministry is not my ability, but it's people that are praying for me. Because he knows that prayer changes things. He realizes that our victory is in prayer. So he says, they say to Samuel, cease not to cry unto the Lord God for us, that he may save us from the Philistines. And Samuel took a sucking lamb and offered it for a burnt offering wholly unto the Lord. And Samuel cried unto the Lord for Israel, and the Lord heard him.
Samuel watabata itakane elanyayo walinyusa lalidini elinyukayo lonke liphela kuYehova. Wakhala uSamuel kuYehova ngenxa yamaFilisti, uYehova wamphendula.
And as Samuel was offering up the burnt offering, the Philistines drew near to battle against Israel. But the Lord thundered with a great thunder on that day upon the Philistines and discomfited them, and they were smitten before Israel.
Kwathi xa uSamuel elinyusayo idini elinyukayo, amaFilisti asondela esiza kulwa namaIsrayeli, uYehova wadudumisa ngezwi elikhulu lomini kumaFilisti, wawaqungaqunga abulawa phambi kwamaIsrayeli.
But the Lord thundered with a great thunder.
This was not their noise now. This was not their emotions now. This was not their enthusiasm now. It was now the Spirit of the Lord amongst them. It was now the power of God that was bringing a revival. Why? They met the requirements. Now they listened to the word of the prophet. And they did according to the word of the prophet. Brother, we want the shout of the Lord in the camp. We want to rejoice in the camp. But we don't want our own emotions. We don't want our own doing. Let it be the Spirit of the Lord that comes from the repentant heart, that comes from the people that bows and obeys the word of the prophet. When the prophet says, we do what he says. We don't want a revival outside the word of the prophet. It brings death. We may be carrying the Ark of the Covenant.
Amen.
We may be carrying the Ark of the Covenant. But if we are leaving the prophet behind, it's a revival that will bring death. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, they conquered.
Apa, boys.
They conquered.
Boys.
Amen.
Amen.
And verse 11, and the men of Israel went out of Mizpah and pursued the Philistines and smote them until they came under Bethkar.
Aphuma amadoda akwaIsrayeli eMizpah awasukela amaFilisti awabulala esaphansi kweBhetekari.
Then Samuel took a stone and set it between Mizpah and Shen and called the name of it Ebenezer, saying, hitherto hath the Lord helped us.
USamuel wathabatha ilitye walimisa phakathi kweMizpah neShen, wathi igama lalo yiEbenezer, wathi kude kwaba lapha uYehova esinceda. Kumzambambuthi ninike umfama. Dinike umakheni. Dinike umfazi ohlala ekhaya. Oya kubeka uThixo oqala. Ndiyakucela, ndiyakubonisa indoda. Ndiyakubonisa umntu. Oya kuphumelela. Kuyo yonke into ayenzayo. Ba ubeka uThixo oqala. Awukwazi ubeka uThixo
oqala. When you put God first, the word of the prophet, you bow under it. And when that happens, brother, through it all, through your hardship, through your difficulties, you will come to a point where you say, Ebenezer, hitherto has the Lord helped me. You will say, I've been through the valleys, I've been through the fires, but I say, Ebenezer, through it all, the Lord has helped me. I have faced the Philistines. I have faced many battles. I have fought with many Philistines. But when I stood under the word of the prophet, I can say, Ebenezer, until this far, the Lord has helped me. That's a true revival, brother. When you go following, meeting the requirements of God for the age. Because Brother Branham says, the message of the hour will cope with the conditions of the age. In order to cope with the conditions of today, you need the message of today. Amen. So the Israelites, we don't hear one person that died now. But when we read in chapter 4, they tried twice. They died in thousands. Not because the word of the prophet was not there, but they left it behind. And the prophet kept quiet until they went back to the word of the prophet. That's when they got a true revival. So the Philistines were subdued, verse 13, and came no more unto the coast of Israel. They were completely defeated. The Philistines.
There's a total deliverance when you come to bow under the word of your age with a heart that turns to God. There's not something where you can say, I've been trying this and I can't get to defeat it. God gives a total deliverance from all unbelief. Says the hand of the Lord was against the Philistines all the days of Samuel. I'm in verse 13 at the end. Are you living in the days of the voice of the seventh angel? The hand of the Lord will be against your Philistines all the days of the voice. As long as you submit to the day to the voice. He told them in book of Exodus, chapter 20, says, I sent my angel before you. Obey his voice. If you obey his voice, I will kill all the Hivites and the Hittites. Amen. And everything that stands before you. As long as you obey his voice, we get a true revival today when we meet the requirements of it. When we meet the requirements of it. It's not a revival of just gathering and shouting. As I will show you next time, the bride's revival starts with the opening of the word. It does not end. It goes with the changing of the body. It's not a revival of shouting and jumping and all that. But it brings that. Amen. It brings that. When it is in you, brother, there's something just like that fountain where the prophet was seeing it bubbling. Always happy. Says, I went to that fountain. Says, I, you know, if I could have spoken to it. Says, I asked it, what makes you so happy? What makes you so bubbling? Says, if that fountain could have been able to speak, amen, he would ask, is it because I'm here? It would say no. Is it because I'm drinking from you? It would say no. But what makes you happy? What makes you bubbly? Says no. What makes me happy? There's a force inside. There's something happening inside that makes the water to come out gushing. That's what's happening to the children of God. We don't just go because the song was nice. We don't just go because it's our favorite preacher. But brother, there's a revival inside. That's
why
I'm going in a taxi.
And
I'm going to work.
There's a joy
inside. And when a sister is washing the dishes, you just get a song that brings a joy inside. And brother, I'm walking in the mall. And I have a communication with God. You just hear me saying hallelujah.
There's a joy
inside. There's a revival happening. Not a
great
revival, but a revival of the bride in the sons of the believers. That's what we are praying for. That's what we are looking for. Says, I never came to build an organization. I never came that people may follow me. But I have come to restore a relationship between God and man. That they will be individuals. That would believe this word and get a connection with God. It will be a revival, brother. That's not ceasing. That's not ending. That will carry you to the change of your body. God bless you. Let's give him the hands of praise.
Let's call Tiko. Hallelujah.
Let's rise on our feet.
Amen.
Sivuselele ngosu Jesu
Sivuselele. Amen. Sivuselele. Kusuchi.
Sivuselele. Kosuche sivuselele, amen. Sivuselele, kosuche
all pray in your own way. Amen. To glory he is changing me. He is changing me. He is changing me. His likeness and image to perfect in me. The love that God shows to
his bride
is changing.
He's changing.
He's changing
me
from the earthly things to the heavenly. His likeness and image to in me, the love that God shows to his bride, from glory to glory, is changed
to me.
Oh, he's changed me. Yes, he's changed me. His likeness and image to perfect in me. The love that
shows to his bride
is changing.
Changing.
Yes, he's changing.
Changing
from the heavenly things
Ask Brother Ayaka to come and close the service in prayer. There's that song. You will have to help me. I don't know if we have it. When he was on the cross, I was on his mind. He knew me, yet he loved me.
For he knew. Yet he loved me. He whose glory made heaven.
Oh, let's sing it to the Lord. So unworthy of such mercy. Oh, so unworthy. Come on, help us, amen. The singers, help us.
Such mercy.
Oh, oh,
such mercy.
When he was on the cross. Oh, when he. I was on his mind. Let's try the verse. You don't know it. I made mistakes and often sleep.
I make mistakes and often sleep. Just come on flesh and bone.
But you will prove someday. Someday. Just what I see, I'm of a special kind. When he was on the cross. He loved me. Oh,
he knew me.
Oh, yes, yes.
He loved me.
He was glory makes. Let's try the chorus for the last time.
so unworthy, oh so unworthy of such mercy.
Let's bow our heads and close our eyes as the brother comes to pray for us. Amen.
Lord, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, for the day that you've given us. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we appreciate you, O Father. Lord, to speak to us in such a wonderful way. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Father, we are grateful. Mighty King of Kings, the government of sins. Oh, Father, we thank you, Father, for this revival. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, for you revive us, oh, Father. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. We are grateful to have God who is like you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, oh, Father, we pray, the government of sins, trust you. Lord Jesus Christ, Nkosi yam sesophuma uphindwe uhambe nathi ke Nkosi ube nathi egameni leNkosi Jesu Christ. We have heard, Nkosi, oh Father, Nkosi yam, that Nkosi, the sin of Israel was not to listen, oh Father, to their prophet, oh Lord. Father, was to fail, Nkosi. Lord Jesus Christ, to hear, oh Father, what their prophet have said. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Father, help us, oh Father, that we may be able, Ngosi, to listen, Father, Ngosi, and follow, Ngosi, Father, oh Lord, oh Father, Ngosi, Lord, what, oh Father, the prophet has said, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and what your word have said, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, help us, oh Father, to die to ourselves, oh Father, to die to our nature, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, Sunday we have told, Father, Ngosi, of Job, Father, what was done, oh Father, to Job? It was, Father, Ngosiam, to remove Job out of Job. In the name of the Lord Jesus, it was to remove the nature of Job. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, your word, oh Father, cleanse us, oh Lord, purifies us, oh Lord, help us, oh Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Father, may we follow you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu, help us at all times. In the name of the Lord Jesus, that we may become like you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, because we are called, oh Father, oh Father, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we are called, Nkosi, ukufana nawe, ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu. Lord, oh Father, help us. Lord, oh Father, ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu, that we may go higher. Ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu Christu, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, because we are not chickens, we are eagles, oh Lord. We are called to fly. Ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Susa eNkosi ubugwenxa bethu, sincede eNkosi yam, oh Father, ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu, sikhona iziphoso zethu. Egameni leNkosi Jesu Christu, sincede eNkosi yam, oh Nkosi yam, egameni leNkosi Jesu, sibe nokuphilela wena Nkosi imihla yonke Nkosi yam, Nkulunkulu wami, ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu. Father, Nkosi yam, that we may reflect you, Nkulunkulu wami, emisebenzini, wherever we are, oh Nkosi. Father, that we may be a reflection of Christ, ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu Christu, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. We are thankful and grateful. Father, we bless your name. Ngiyagama leNkosi Jesu, we pray. Father, Nkosi yam, ibanathi. We pray for Nambanga Koyangosiam, Ibanabo Gosiam, Yakama Negosius, because of various reasons. In the name of the Lord Jesus, bless us. Bless your saints, Yakama Negosius, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. You may take your seats, saints. God bless you. As it was announced on Sunday. I was not here on Sunday. I'm changing nothing. As it was announced on Sunday, we will continue like that. Amen.
Amen.
Did we say we're going to Stellenbosch on Friday?
Okay.
So we'll be in Stellenbosch on Friday. I want to ask, you know, this yard, we need to keep on maintaining it. Now, the grass is too much here. It doesn't look neat at all. And it's quick and easy to remove it. If we can get, you know, some of us that can come here, maybe Saturday, 10 o'clock, it will take us just 1 hour or even less than that, we'll be finished with it. Let's come and clean it. Make it look nice. We are getting a lot of visitors that come here. No, they must come and find the place at least looking looked after. So brothers, can we do it on Saturday, 10 o'clock?
Amen.
I see no hands coming up. Brothers, can we do it on Saturday, 10 o'clock? Amen. Okay. No, but let's clean it. We don't have another time. Let's do it this Saturday. We'll do it this Saturday. Amen.
Amen.
So God bless you. Take the name of Jesus with you. I'm not going to delay you further. We may dismiss from the front. God bless you. Thank you.